Hare Krishna, 9th chapter, 30th verse, Bhagavad Gita. Api cheta sujara acharo, bhajate mamananyabha, sadureva samantavyaha, samyak vavasato hisaha. Even if one commits the most abominable action, if he is engaged in devotee service, he is to be considered saintly because he is properly situated. This shloka has many dimensions. Needs a lot of deep realizations. Okay, first understand the meaning. Api chet su durachar. Even if somebody has committed the most abominable activity, durachar means bad. Durachar means very bad. Api chet su duracharo. But there is one thing he is doing. Bhajate mam anane bhag is still engaged in devotional service. We have to take him as a sadhu. Samyak vivasito hisa. If he is so continuously engaged in devotional service, he should be accepted as sadhu even if there was an accidental fall down. First, let us understand what is accidental fall down. Accidental fall down means, take an example. One devotee was a drunkard before, and he didn't plan. He just went to meet his friends to maybe give them Bhagavad Gita, this Gita Jayanti, and all the friends caught him and said you should drink, and he was previously a drunkard. He didn't plan it. In their company he falls back to his old habit. There is no plan. That is called accidental, and he slipped. Just like Ajamila fall down is called accidental. He didn't plan. He just went to the forest. He saw some, prostitute embracing a man. And he just slipped. Boom. That is accidental. Correct? Not planned. Planned is separate. I remember I used to tell many times when father, mother used to go. Father goes to office. Mother goes to market. We two brothers used to switch on the TV. That is planned. That is not accidental. But Durdarshan those days, what you will see? Something funny. But whatever it is, that is planned. That is not accidental. You will not be forgiven for something planned. But accidental, yes. Krishna says, sadhu revasa mantavya. Why? Prabhupada said, Krishna is sitting in his heart, he will beautify. Beautify. But then, if somebody is slipping, Prabhupada says, just like a small child is there, he slips. Now, just because a child is sleeping, mother is patient. Not that whole life he slips. Okay, we should start to walk. Not that I will keep sleeping my life. You have to learn how to walk. You cannot say, Krishna is very kind, I'll keep sleeping. Theek hai? You are a devotee, but only to be given respect externally. Hare Krishna. That's it. There is Prakita Sahajiya. Prakita Sahajiya, Prabhupada said, he takes Diksha, he takes initiation. There is Guru for him, there is Krishna for him. He just cannot relate to any devotee. He's a Kanishtha. Kanishtha Adhikari cannot respect devotees. A Guru is there, Krishna is there. Yeah, some people are very fine with it. Good, you're Kanishtha. Correct or not? Kanishtha means he cannot respect devotees. Madhyama means when he understands, what is the Madhyama principle? Ishwara tadadineshu. He loves the Lord and the Guru. And then, tadadineshu, devotees, he feels very friendly to the devotees. Tadadineshu. He is not struggling to relate to devotees. See, I don't know why struggle is there. I think struggle is there because you are too self-centered. Always I am thinking what other person is thinking about me. Anna? What is the realization on this? Anybody? Why do we struggle to relate to? Because we are thinking about ourselves only. Anna? If you are thinking of Guru's mission and Krishna, you should be so happy to see a devotee. Oh, who is this devotee? Decorated the deity so nicely today. You feel so happy. Who is devotee who has cooked so nicely today? Correct? You feel happy with every, because you want to serve Krishna. I can't do it. Somebody has done it. You feel very happy. See, that is atadadineshu. You feel friendly. Ishvara tadadineshu. Balisheshu. Those who are innocent, we feel merciful to them. And then, and those who are envious, we ignore them. There is no anger in the heart of a devotee. So then, if somebody is slipping down, then he's in neophyte platform. Then externally we respect him. We can't relate. So sadhu revasa mantevya is sadhu, but kanishta sadhu. You cannot say, see, I was drinking yesterday and now I am chanting Hare Krishna. So they went to distribute Bhagavad Gita somewhere. So they saw one person, and you know they are so-called Brahmins. We all know they are fish-eating Brahmins. मालूम मछली खाने वाले ब्राह्मण है ना किसका नाम बता तो वहाँ देखा कुछ लोग वहाँ मंदिर से बाहर आए सिगरेट पी रहे थे और भगवत गीता नया नहीं वहाँ पर है हमारे पास है हमको मालूम है सब मालूम है और वो जनेऊ चेंज करके चले जाते हैं आरती के लिए अंदर हमने देखा दारू पिया सिगरेट पिया फिर जनेऊ चेंज किया अंदर मंदिर के पूजा भी हो जाती है सो दिस इज ही विल से आई एम कृष्णा सेज यू नो अपिचे तो सुजराचारो नंबर वन It is accidental fall down, not planned, correct? You cannot cheat Krishna. Because if you cheat Krishna, then something else will come. Mithyachari cha uchyate Indriyani samyamya Yaste manasasmaran Indriyarteshu Sorry, starts with Karma indriyani samyamya Yaste manasasmaran Indriyarteshu Indriyani and Deyartheshu Samathyachari sa uchyate Karma Indriyani Samyamya All the senses he is controlling. Bada big tilak he is putting. But all senses he is controlling externally. Logo dikha raha hai, mere ko kuch matlab nahi duniya se. Indriyani Samyamya Yaste Manasasvaran But mind is involved in Indriyartheshu Indriyani Indriyartheshu Senses are still internally he is Thinking about sense objects. What does Krishna say for him? Krishna says, Sadhu Revasa Mantavya, what does Krishna say for him? Mithyachari Suji, he bhupakre. So there we have to see. Correct? It's a balance, no? Isn't it? If he's planned fall down, he's a hypocrite then. See, just like you are a teacher, madam. Now suppose a student comes to you and he says, Madam, today you know what happened, one mistake happened. My watch alarm did not work and I got up late. So I'm late for the college. It happened accidentally. You'll forgive me. Okay? But in case he plans to tell you this lie, will you forgive him? You say you are a hypocrite. You're a liar. But if somebody is genuine, you forgive. So we are trying to serve Krishna. We are sincere and genuine in that. Accidentally it happened. That I had, habit is second nature. It's not easy to give up habit, correct? But also remember, if you are having an accident fall down, you are a neophyte. Don't say respect me because you are only to be given external respect. Somebody is paying obeisance, please stop. Because Madhyamadhikari can be given obeisance, Uttamadhikari we surrender. The Madhyamadhikari is not falling down. What do you say? Am I right? Because Nectar of Instruction now says the six principles of interaction. Six principles of interaction are to be, next shloka says how to be done. Nectar of instruction, agar padhenge upadesha mehta, usse bolte hai ki chhe tarah se hum bhakton ka sang le sakte hai. Ek kya hota hai? Who knows the shloka? Dadati pratigrahanati. Bhai kuch do usko gift, aap usse gift receive karo. That is the first thing. Then, first bhungte? Haan, then. You reveal your mind and he gives some instruction to you. Take it then? You give something to it, he gives something to it. Now next shloka Prabhupada says, these six things, how to be done, this shloka is going to tell. Not that we do blindly these six things. Because Kanishta Madhyama Uttamaitari, you have to do these six things carefully with them. Totally surrendering, revealing mind is to Uttamadhikari, not to another Kanishta Adhikari. Wo to japna jab bhi karna chhod dega. Bata bada problem hai, bahut problem hai. Itna saal se jab kar raha hu, but kabhi kabhi aata hai. Aisa hota hai kya? Wo jab mara raha kya bhag jayega. So you cannot reveal your mind to a Kanishta. You reveal your mind to somebody. And another thing is that you reveal your mind to somebody, it is like dumping your dustbin in his garden. Why you are disturbing him? You reveal your mind to somebody, take instruction. If you are not taking instruction, don't reveal your mind. What's the point? Anna? That becomes another sense of, Prabhu, I am very fallen. No, you should chant Hare Krishna. No, don't tell me that. Then why you are telling me on this? You go to doctor. The doctor, you know, temperature is very high. The doctor said, take that medicine. No, I am not going to follow you. What doctor said? Why are you wasting my time then? What isn't it? If some patient comes to doctor and reveals his situation, the very purpose is that he accepts the medicine. If he is not accepting medicine, then there is no point in revealing the situation. It makes sense? Take care? So just understand this balance. So there can be no accidental fall on. That's clear. And next thing comes, six dealings have to be done according to the Kanishta Madhyama and Uttama. Now, how do you define Kanishta Madhyama Uttama? Now, go to this. Kanishta Adhikari, I just gave definition. Kanishta, various ways. Even initiation is not relating, is not understanding. The Lord is Paramatma residing in everybody's heart, is Kanishta. Kanishta, also called Prakita Sahajiya. Kanishta Adhikari can fall down. Also, if you are falling down regularly, means you are Kanishta. One thing very easy. Take care. Madhyama Adhikari, Prabhupada says, he will not fall down. So that is easy to understand. If you are able to strongly follow four regulative principles, don't need to take certificate, you are Madhyama Adhikari now. Okay? Madhyama Adhikari also says, constantly chanting the names of the Lord. That's another qualification. Madhyama Adhikari is very easily able to relate with the four things very nicely. He loves the Lord. He loves the Guru. He has friendship with all the devotees. He has compassionate to these people. And is very, very ignores the envious. Uttama Adhikari in this shloka proper defines differently. Be very careful. Some people do a total mess up. Many devotees explain that. The definition of Uttama Adhikari by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and definition of Uttama Adhikari in this shloka is different. Because it says only take Uttama Adhikari is Diksha Guru. Look at the definition of Diksha Guru in this shloka. Just like in Nectar of Instruction. The first shloka also says, you can become a guru if you have vacha vegam, manasa vegam, krodha vegam. That's not the definition of paramahamsa devotee. That's for anybody strict follower of the regulative principles. Correct? Vacha vegam, manasa krodha vegam, jiva vegam, utarapastha vegam. He can become a guru. It says or not? But that's not the definition of a person who is flowing a love of Krishna. He's much higher than this. This is just ABCD for him. True? I'm just saying, a regular guru, maybe having vacha vegam, manasa krodha vegam, but we're not flowing in the love of Krishna, but he can still do the service. Just trying to reconcile. So in this shloka, the definition is actually different. Kanishta, Madhyama, Uttama. The Uttama definition is totally absorbed in the mission of the Lord, always trying to expand the mission of the Lord. It does not say the waves and lahars of love of Krishna flowing in his heart. Correct? Which generally we know as Uttama Adhikari, because that's how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu defines. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says Uttama Adhikari means by seeing him you become a devotee. By seeing him you become a Mahabhava. That's what we think of Uttama Adhikari, correct? It doesn't say that in the shloka. Be careful to note that point. Many devotees have identified that. Okay, so this is one more part. So we carefully understand Kanishta Madhyama Uttama. Kanishta means sometimes falling down. Madhyama Adhikari does not fall down. Uttama cannot fall down. Madhyama does not fall down, but harassment is there. Does not fall down. Uttama is now sthayi bhava, cannot fall down. A simple definition, making it approachable. Take care. And so in this way, so this is fall down will not occur. So at this stage, sudurachara, there is no question of Uttama Adhikari having. There was once when somebody asked Srila Prabhupada, is it that acharya need not be a pure devotee? So Prabhupada said, why? Who is that idiot who said that? Prabhupada said, you read the conversation? Now Prabhupada Nitaya, he's telling that, he has become very learned now. Because he was a Sanskrit translator. Now he's speaking nonsense. No, he's saying the Brahma, he ran after his daughter, but he's still Acharya. So Acharya need not be pure devotee. Prabhupada, nonsense. He became very upset. That he did before hearing Bhagavata and becoming the Sampradaya Acharya. Prabhupada says. So I said, no, this kind of conception should not be there. Okay. So, api chetu sudaracharo bhajate maam ananyabhaga savut sadureva samantyava samyagvava sotisaha. Very, very important point now, another dimension. This shows love of Krishna. This shows the love of Krishna. Previous shloka was what? Krishna is equal to everybody. What is the shloka? Samoham sarvabhuteshu namadvashyasi na priyaha. Then, ye tu bhajanti tu. He says, I am equal to everybody, but somebody comes to love me, I love him. Correct? Just like you are a dean of the college, he may be equal to all the people, but somebody approaches him with love, then he also reciprocates with love. That's true for all of us. In our profession, our duty, we are equal to everybody. It's natural. But our own child, somebody may be very specially. Purpose is that's not artificial, that's natural. So when somebody approaches Krishna with love, yetu bhajanti tumam bhaktya, Krishna becomes. So similarly for a bhakta, this concession Krishna is giving, not giving for ordinary people, correct? Krishna is giving a concession for a bhakta. If he is continuously engaged, the condition was is continuously engaged. Therefore, if somebody's sadhana is weak, then he will not get up. Suppose somebody is sadhana achha. साधना बहुत ध्यान से करता है, टाइम से उठता है, बहुत ध्यान से, एक एक चीज इंपॉर्टेंट है, ये नहीं कट पेस्ट सर्वमेतम ऋतम मान्ये यद मन यद वदसि मन केशवा. नाउ टू सी हाउ डू वी डोंट फॉल डाउन, द चैप्टर इज ओवर. सो हाउ टू डेवलप फेथ दैट विल नॉट मेक अस फॉल डाउन. यू सी व्हेन प्रभुपाद आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल लाइन ऑफ भगवद गीता, प्रभुपाद सेड इन द वृंदावन भजन वेयर इज सिटिंग इन वृंदावन, प्रभुपाद राइट्स the most beautiful line of Bhagavad Gita is, this Bhagavad Gita is so nice because it has a beautiful line for a devotee. What is that? Sarvam etam ritam manye yadavadasi mana keshava. Krishna, I accept every word you say. If you do that, you'll not fall down. You accept every word Krishna says. See, when we are falling down, when material desires are coming, when we are not advancing, there is, and when our faith is weak, there is some duplicity in our surrender to Guru and Krishna. Correct? So I say I accept every word Guru Krishna say. Every word Prabhupada says I accept it. If you do that, that's very nice. Correct? Sarvamitam Ritamari. You accept everything Krishna says. Then we are going to advance. We generally don't do that. We have our own conception. Everybody wants that he is in a prestigious position. Leave it. Everybody thinks he is in a prestigious position, and in case and he adjusts the philosophy and he accepts only those instructions which put him on that prestigious position, and those instructions that show that actually are compromising, he ignores them. That's what we all do. Just like I'll think I'm in a very prestigious position, but I'm a bahut aaj Prabhupada ji ye bole hai chodo, I'll not accept that. That is not true. Then how do you advance? Those who are humble, yes, I am doing something, but yeah, I have to do this, I have to do this. Then he will advance, no? Prabhupada said, he should not be resentful for advancing in Krishna consciousness. It should not be chalta hai. And then how? Prabhupada explains very nicely. He says, it's like a football. First, we should understand our position. Our position is like a football. Football ka koi position hi nahi hota. जिसने देखा अगर फुटबॉल बाहर रखा है, पहले चीज़ एक लात तो मार ही देता कोई, है ना, उसका उसका काम ही है लात खाना. फिर जहाँ थोड़ा पड़ा वो किसी बच्चे ने देखा एक लात वो भी मार देगा. तो हमारा भी जिंदगी फुटबॉल की तरह चल रहा है, अभी इधर अभी कभी उधर, कभी इधर कभी उधर, ट्रू ना. अभी इंडिया में, फिर बर्मा में, फिर चाइना में, अगले जन्म में अमेरिका में, फिर रशिया में, फिर इंडिया में. आ ब्रह्म भुवना लोका पुनरावर्तन अर्जुना, ठीक है, माम उपेत कुतु कौन थे या पुनर्जन्म देते, तो पूरे ब्रह्मांड में हम घूम रहे हैं. करें, सो वी आवर पोजिशन इज लाइक अ फुटबॉल, वी आर बीइंग किक्ड here, there. First, you should understand what is my condition. Because unless you understand your condition, how you are going to advance in Krishna consciousness? Is it possible? First, we have to understand our position. What is my position? I am like a football. There is no position only. I am being kicked here, there, there. Prabhupada says, sometimes we think I will be destroyed. You are already destroyed. You are already destroyed. My nature of Sachidananda, what, where is eternity, where is knowledge, and where is bliss? I am already destroyed. Isn't it true? So, Krishna's protection is actually spiritual. When Krishna says in the next shloka, Shipram Bhavati Dharmatma. So, Prabhupada says when devotee is practicing Krishna consciousness, naturally the 26 qualities of a Vaishnava should develop in him. They should come out. Therefore, Krishna is a little patient. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Krishna is very patient. Okay? But in case there is sometimes, and in fact, that's how Prabhupada preached in America. Prabhupada said, had I said this fault, that fault, yet the movement should be new. Correct? The movement would not have begun only. Okay? So movement would not even have started in America. Therefore, the Rupa Goswami Shloka comes. Yenikena upayena mana Krishna niveshayet sarva vidhi nishedashu etayoreva kinkaraha. In fact, Prabhupada, God brothers could not understand this. They were started finding fault. Prabhupada was very, very patient. When his God brothers, we know, had gone to England to start the movement, Bon Maharaj and other devotees, they failed. They had a golden contact, the person who was a governor in India. Britisher, top man. He was very interested in becoming Krishna conscious. He rather met them and he said, can you make me a Brahmana? Just imagine, he was so impressed with our culture. And they said, you want to become a Brahmana? You have to follow no intoxication, including tea, coffee, no meat eating, no onion, garlic, no. He said, impossible, and went away. But what did Prabhupada do? When people are coming to Prabhupada Prabhachana in the morning, jab aare the, drugs khake aare the. वहाँ अभी भी ऐसा ही है. अगर कोई आपको स्टूडेंट 8 बजे या 6 बजे जगह मिलता है तो ये गारंटी ले लो वो सो के नहीं उठा है, सोया नहीं है. अगर आपको 6 बजे कोई लड़का मिलता है हॉस्टल में, ये कभी नहीं सोचें गलती से भी कि उठा है, वो सोया ही नहीं है. उतना बजे कोई नहीं उठता अभी. ऐसी हालत इंडिया में भी हो गई है ना. ऐसा ही हालत हो गया, 2 बजे, 3 बजे, 4 बजे, है ना माता जी. ऐसा वही सेम स्टाइल. तो Prabhupada used to have, so they, who were the people who were coming to Prabhupada ki subah ke pravachan mein, puri raat ko jage the, drugs kha rahe the, daru pee rahe the, aur wo thande ho ke hota na, there is depression and disturbed, they used to just come for some nice music, aise log. I tell you, we are there, will say, out, out, get out, hum to bhaga denge un log ko. And I have an experience like that. We don't have. What Prabhupada is doing? Yena kena upayena mana Krishna niveshayet, correct? Prabhupada did not even put 4 niyam tak apna board mein nahi lagaya when he opened ISKCON in America for 6 months. 6 mahine tak unko pata bhi nahi tha ki kya 4 niyam hote. Just they were hearing Prabhupada chanting in the morning, class in the morning, class in the evening and kirtan. That's all was going on for good time. Yena kena upayena. So this is the process actually which Prabhupada applied.